Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, thank you. You have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the great shepherd, guiding us to the everlasting life. Almighty God, have mercy on us, and give us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in all our lives, and God bless us to continue to make good work. We pray and pray and ask you, we have God in you, we have all our sins, we have your sins, we have all the work to do, we have all the work to do, and we have the kingdom. Favor, O Lord, to your servant, and mercifully increase the gift of your grace. And your servant, hope, faith, and shepherd, and may the giver watch for and keep me your commandments. Thank you, through our Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit. good. God set up our own strength. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to Jacob, when a woman named Martha brought unto him his complaint, he asked sister named Mary, beautifully soft for Jesus' feet and listen to his word. Martha heard him speak to her hospitality. Came to him and said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to tend the flock during the survey? Come and help me." Jesus in reply said to her, "Martha, Martha, you are anxious and worried about many things. There is a need for only one thing. There is chosen by God, and it will not be taken." In the singular, Father, you have chosen our hospitality. In other words, God has revealed himself as a trinity of persons to labor on. And when we understand that he himself will receive an answer to the greatest prayer, we become patient. And in that same chapter, we learn that sorrow is beyond God, there he is, and he's never had a child. Abraham trusts the Lord, and his faith is greatly rewarded. It's also the focus of a very brief gospel text that we're going to see just in a moment. Jesus has stopped in a village just a short distance from Jerusalem, and he is visiting the home of Martha and Mary, the sisters of Lazarus. Now, Martha and Mary very different ideas about how Jesus should be welcomed into their home. For Martha, he is a very important guest, and she feels as if it is a royal feast. Be aware that Jesus will not be with them much longer, and therefore he does not want to leave his feet for even more. That Jesus died for the sins of Mary. So surely, that Mary should be serving the guests and not wasting time at his feet. But Jesus favors
Thank you.
intimate relationship with us. There are prayers that help us to have the desire to stick with you, to free us through Christ our Lord. God, who is one perfect sacrifice, brought to completion during offering of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servant, and make us holy as you bless this surrender, so that what is offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord of our Lord. It is truly great and just, and due to all of salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your revealed Son, Jesus Christ. In a word, you will be made all things. When you sanctify our Savior and Redeemer, in penance for the Holy Spirit, the blood of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, a such sort of way to see your glorious passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with angels of all of us, we declare thee our glory, as with one voice, I'm going to go to the next slide. widening gate, holy Lord, thought of all in a similar way, when suffering was done, he took the cross. And once more, giving thanks, he gave the precious disciples strength. This is all of you, and great Christ. And this is the child of my soul. The blood of the newest holy covenant, which will be poured out for you in heaven. All the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Memorial of His death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. This fact that you have held us worthy to be in thy presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by taking out the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one body. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our hope, with Bowman and Justified Bishop, and with all those of you who have been joined. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all of the saints who have praised you throughout the ages, raise those merits to be co-heirs to eternal life. And may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Welcome and welcome and welcome, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus Christ come among us, and I'm informed by his writing and teaching all his life. I was a part of the world. A survivor is called to the second of the Lord. Thank you.